2-year-old Tilly and 9-week-old Bonnie. Just two of the many children supported by Plunket.
I couldn't tell you how many times we've called Plunket line in a stress in the middle of the night or whatever.
Around for decades, the organisation supports nearly 300,000 families a year. Now it's in so much financial strife, it's had to sell assets and reduce services.
Families are missing out because of this. So we have, in some ways, the perfect storm of events. So we have a funding shortfall, pure and simple. We also have an incredibly tight labour market.
The government's already contributed an extra $5 million this year, but Plunket is still struggling.
We are still $1.4 million short for our basic Plunket Nursing Well Child Tamariki Kia Ora service.
We've made sure we've supported them both by helping them address their deficit and by providing a funding increase this year. We're continuing to work with them to make sure we support their services.
You can do hands and knees rocking.
Warning bells are now sounding in the midwifery sector too. The College of Midwives taking the Health Ministry to court over pay and working conditions.
So many whānau are not getting that gold standard continuity of care because we are losing more and more midwives. We have a huge shortage. We are one of the workforces with the biggest shortage.
A challenge felt right across the health sector.
There's not another place for people to go that is publicly funded. Yeah, so people will suffer if it's not there.
Calls continuing for stronger support so our kids aren't left behind. Abby Wakefield, One News.